Welcome back to the SST classroom. How are you all? I hope you are fit and fine. So, today we are going to discuss new chapter. But before starting a new chapter, I will show you a picture. You have to look at that picture and you have to identify which picture is this. Okay? So, are you ready? Now look at the first picture. Can you identify this picture? Yes, my dear children. This picture is a mountain. Now look at the second picture. Can you identify this picture? This picture is of plains. Yes, you're right. Now look at the third picture. This picture is of desert. So we have discussed the first physical division, that is Northern Mountain. Right? We discussed chapter number 1, that is Northern Mountain. Then we discussed the second chapter, that is Northern Plains. Right? And then we discussed the third chapter, that is Northern Indian Desert. So what all are these? These we are discussing the physical features of India. There are 6 physical divisions you have learned in the first standard, that is Northern Mountain, Northern Plains, Indian Desert, Southern Plateau, Coastal Plain and Island Region. So now today we are going to discuss the 4th physical division, that is Plateaus of India. What we are going to discuss today? Chapter number 4, Plateaus of India. Now before starting this chapter, first again you have to look at the picture. Look at this map. This is the map of India. Now my dear student, can you tell me where you can see ice cream cone on the map? Come on, look at the map. You know ice cream cone? How is the shape of the ice cream cone? Can you tell me? It is triangular in shape. So where can you see the triangular shape on the map? Yes, my dear children, you are right. It is in the southern part of India. So today we are going to discuss about the southern part of India, that is Plateaus of India. Okay, now before starting this Plateaus of India, you should know the concept of plateau. You know what is plateau? Can you tell me what is plateau? Now plateau means the land which is higher than its surrounding area, the land which is flat and higher than its surrounding area is known as plateau. It is a table structure. You have seen the table. Now look at this picture. This is a picture of table. So how is the table? It is a flat on the top. Right? So same here, you will see the plateau also. It is a flat on the top. Okay? It looks like a table land. Got it? So, in your book, what the definition is given about the plateau? That a raised area with steep slope. You can raise area means a higher area with steep slope and flat top is called plateau. Got it? Hope you have cleared the concept of plateau. So, in simple words, you can say a land which is flat and higher than its surrounding area is known as plateau. The land which is flat and higher than its surrounding area is known as plateau. And this area is also rocky area and also called table land. Okay, now let's start with the plateau of India. First we will discuss the peninsular plateau. Now my dear children, you know what is peninsula? Means The land masses, now look at this map. The land masses which is surrounded by three water bodies, you can say it is surrounded by the water three sides, it is known as peninsula. Now which water it is surrounded, you can see here in the picture, it is surrounded by Arabian Sea in the west, you can see on the map, and Indian Ocean in the south, Bay of Bengal in the east. So the land masses which is surrounded by three water bodies is known as peninsula. Got it? Hope you have cleared the concept of peninsula. So what I discuss about the peninsula? The land masses which is surrounded by water three sides is known as peninsula. Now Indian Peninsula, here we discuss about the peninsula plateau. Now it covers a large part of the southern, it covers the large part of the country. Now let's see the location of the peninsula plateau. So it is located to the south of the northern plain. You can see on the map the northern plains which lie here to the south of northern mountain, first northern mountain, second northern plains. So to the south of the northern plain, the whole this area, the large part of the country, it is covered with the peninsular plateau. Got it, my children? Now it is broad on the north, you can see it is broad on the north and it is narrow in the south. Now peninsular plateau, it is surrounded by hill all sides. You can see which hills it is surrounded. So here the name of the hill is given, Aravali Hills. Look at the map carefully so you will understand, you should clear your concept. So here you see it is surrounded by hill all sides, that is Aravali Hills. We have discussed the third chapter, Aravali Hills. In the west, and where which desert is there? Indian Desert. So you see here in the picture, Aravali Hills, and then second, Raj Mahal Hills. Third, Eastern Ghat on the east, and Western Ghat on the west. So it is surrounded by all these hills all side. Now, most of the river which flow in this plateau region are seasonal river. As we have learned, in up the northern plains, that is a perennial rivers, it flows throughout the year. But here in this plateau, here the rivers are seasonal river. So it is not as big as the northern plain. We see the northern plains rivers are very big, right? So here the plateau, the river which flow in the plateau is not as big as the northern plain. And however, they flow with a great speed and they form a waterfall. Mostly you see in the rainy season, you can, if you get the chance, go. And then afterward you go out, and mostly in the rainy season, you see the waterfall. You can see in the area also somewhere you see the waterfall. So same here, this river, when they flow with a great speed, they form waterfall. So here the highest waterfall, that is the Jog Fall, it is in Karnataka. It is one of the highest waterfall in India. You can see the picture here, the waterfall, right? And then second, that is the Kunchikal. Kunchikal Falls, it is also the highest waterfall, and this waterfall, it is the second highest in the Asia. No, Asia, right? So this is the second highest waterfall in the Asia. So one homework for you, you have to find out which is the first highest waterfall in the Asia. You have to find out the name. Okay. Now, afterward we discuss here the river Narmada. It divides the plateau into two parts. Which river divide the plateau into two parts? River Narmada. It divides the plateau into two parts. You can see, first that is the central highland. Second, you see the Deccan Plateau. Now, this both we are going to discuss in the next video. Okay, I hope you have understood the concept of the plateau and peninsular plateau which we discussed, the location, everything. Okay, now what you have to do? Open your textbook, read the concept and underline the important points. Thank you.